Thank you. Namaste. Vanakkam. Okay, please take your seats. Thank you. Welcome to Date with Destiny. And congratulations for being here. I'm very worried when a guy says, I love you. Okay, so how many of you are from India? Okay. I thought we were in Thailand. So we have India, do we have Kuwait? Kuwait. Vietnam, NUM, Vietnam, where else? Oh, they're using translation, so it's delayed. So when I tell a joke, some of you will laugh first and some of you will laugh later. Second time. Okay, I'm very happy to be here. I'm happy that I will be able to talk to you for a few minutes. My name is Sathi Sanati Raja. And I come from Malaysia. How many of you have seen me live before? Really? Where? Vcon, okay. DWD and Vcon. Okay, how many of you are seeing me for the first time? I don't understand. I said, how many of you have seen me live before? Everybody raised your hands. Then I said, how many of you are seeing me for the first time? Everybody raised their hands. Okay, so I've been with QNET now for 22 years. Yeah. And I know some of you are thinking, 22 years and he's still working. When is he going to retire? But I cannot retire because all of you are not maxing out yet. So please start to max out so I can retire. Okay? I think instead of flying to Thailand all the time, the next DWD, we have it in India. Yep. So, my family is known as the QNET family because everybody is in QNET. I have two brothers. Maybe some of you know them. My elder brother is my partner Kuna Senatiraja. And my younger brother is Chief Patman. Okay. I don't understand. You're shouting for him more than me, but I'm here. You can shout when he comes on stage. Now shout at me, okay? Okay. So, all of you has decided that your life is lousy. And that's why you joined QNET, to change your life. True? Okay. So this is one amazing business. We've been around for 22 years, and we are going to be around for many, many more years to come. And all I can wish for is that all of you stay with us for the next 22 years. Okay. How many of you flew to Bangkok in economy class? Okay. So I want you to do something for me. If we have DWD in Bangkok again next year, I want all of you to come in business class. Okay? Because the only reason you came in economy class because you don't have money. True? And that's why you joined QNET. So you can make money and start flying business class and first class. Yeah? Because economy class is lousy. True? Especially you sit down and two fat people come and sit next to you. Yeah? And you're sitting in the middle and you want to go to the bathroom. And you have to cross the guy like this. And then you go to the bathroom, you come back, and you have to cross him again. And there's turbulence and you fall on him. So you have to stop that. Start flying business class. Okay? So now you've become a networker. Your life is going to change. All the things that you normally do, you can't do anymore. Okay? Like, how many of you like to go partying? Okay? Now, you got to stop partying until you make money so that you and I can party together somewhere in the world. Okay? We go to Las Vegas and party. Now, is QNET easy or difficult? Easy or difficult? Difficult. If easy, why are you not maxing out? So it's a little bit difficult, correct? People laugh at you. Your family doesn't believe in the business. Your husband or wife doesn't believe in the business. Put your phones down. You don't have to record. It will be on YouTube. Okay, you can watch it on YouTube later. Now focus on what I have to say. We don't have much time. The most difficult part about the business is not convincing others, but convincing yourself. Okay? You have to decide today that you are going to do this. And you cannot do it 90%. You got to give 100%. And don't care what people say. Because people who say this business doesn't work, doesn't drive a Ferrari. They drive a Tata. What's the small car called? Nano. They drive Nano and they say this business won't work. Okay? So don't listen to people. Now, the only reason why your family doesn't believe in the business is because you're not making money. If you make $10,000 a week, what do you think your husband or wife will say? Why are you staying home? Go and show the plan. Correct? So that's what you need to focus on. Now, have you heard anyone say money is not everything? Yes? Who says that? Huh? People who don't have money will say that. I never once heard Bill Gates say money is not everything. Have you heard money cannot buy you happiness? Yes? Is that true? I've never seen somebody buying a Ferrari and crying at the same time. Okay? So you need, number one, you need to convince yourself that this business works. Then only you can convince others. If you don't believe this business works, then how are you going to convince somebody? Okay? It's like, if you don't believe in the business and you're trying to sign people up, it's like you go to church and listen to a priest who does not believe in God. Correct? So you have to convince yourself that this business is going to work. Now, you have enough proof. You see all your uplines sitting at the back there? They have made it in the business. And the business is so easy. All you have to do is find three on the left and three on the right. And you make money. Okay? In the beginning, you will do three and three once a month. And then you do three and three once a week. Then you do three and three once a day. And then you'll reach a point where you drink coffee, 3 and 3 happens. You take a shower, 3 and 3 happens. You sleep, 3 and 3 happens. Okay? So in the beginning, I know it's difficult. Some of you have 3 on the left and 2 on the right. And to get that one more is so difficult. Correct? But one day you cannot stop the business. Suddenly you open your genealogy and you see Brazil. 30 people joining. Argentina, 20 people joining. And one day my dream is to open my genealogy and see China. Can you imagine? India on the left, China on the right. Then you can book your Ferrari immediately. Okay? But there is one big problem. As soon as you join QNET, something happens. What happens? Do you know what happens when you join QNET? A war starts inside of you. Okay? Because there's two people inside of you. One person is called Mike, one person is called John. Have you heard of them? Have you met them? You meet them every day. Okay? Mike is the good guy. He likes working hard. He wants financial freedom. He wants to max out. John is lazy. Wants to party. Doesn't want you to work hard. Wants you to relax. Okay? All your life, you have been listening to John. Correct? After you join QNET, your only purpose is to kill John. Every training that you go to, the people is going to teach you how to kill John. Have you heard John speak before? Have you heard him speak? Yes or no? No? Now you cannot hear him because he's scared of me. But as soon as you go out, he's going to talk to you. He's going to say, psst. What did the Malaysian say? Don't listen to him. He's from Malaysia. He's not from India. He doesn't know our problems. And he only has 20 million. We have 1 billion. And you, somehow, will start listening to him. Okay? As soon as you go back after DWD, what will John say? Today, we rest. We start tomorrow. That's what he'll say. Mike will say, no, from the airport, go and show the plan or meet your people. But John will say, go back. Sleep, rest, and we will start tomorrow. The next day comes, John will say, today is Sunday, family day. We start tomorrow. And after 5 years, you still come back to DWD, sitting down and listening to somebody speak. After 10 years, it's going to be the same. Unless you decide that you're going to kill John. Okay? Because John will say, this business doesn't work. There's so many negative news in the newspaper, on TV about QNET. This is not a good company. What must you do? What must you do? Just say, shut up, John. Okay, because 22 years ago, one man, Dato Sri Vijay, he said, I'm going to start a company and one day we will be the biggest company in the world. And John told him, don't be silly. It won't work. Now, if he had listened to John 22 years ago, we won't be here today. Correct? So what he did was, he said, shut up, John, and we are 22 years old today. So in the next 5, 10, 15 years, every day you will face a battle. And some of you, there's thousands of you here, some of you will listen to John and quit the business. You understand? But some of you will say, shut up, John, and stand on stage and share your story. But it's not going to be easy. Because John is very strong. Because every time you listen to John, Mike becomes smaller and weaker. You understand? So all your life, you've been listening to John. So Mike is very small. But every time you say, shut up, John, and listen to Mike, John becomes smaller, Mike becomes bigger. And ultimately, we will kill John. When you kill John, then you'll be standing on stage as a maxed out king or queen. But it's not going to be easy. Because while you are here in DWD, all your Johns are next door in another training. And they're talking about me. So the John there is saying, listen, VP Sathi is next door, asking them to kill us. Don't worry. After he leaves, we will go and talk to everybody. Okay? And it's about how many battles you win in a day. And some you will lose, but some you'll win. Okay? Like for example, cricket finals, World Cup, India versus Pakistan. At the same time, there's a training. What will you do? John will say, India, Pakistan. Forget the training, it's the same thing they're going to talk. They're going to talk about the 8 basic building blocks. Today we don't have to go through the system. We'll go next week. That's when you must say, shut up, John. Because whether India wins or Pakistan wins, you're still flying economy class. But if you go for the system, there's a chance we'll be sitting next to each other in first class. Small battles, sometimes you will lose. You know? Like after a meal, you see the gulab jamun, you take one. Mike says, one enough. John says, take two. What will you do? That battle, okay, let John win one time, take two and enjoy your gulab jamun. But regarding QNET, don't ever let John win. That's when you will fail in QNET. You understand? When you want to pick up the phone to call a prospect, John will talk to you. Don't call now, it's late. Then you listen and you don't call. What do you must say? Shut up, John, and call the prospect and show him the plan. Okay? Now, if you go to Dubai, you go to Malaysia, you go to Indonesia, you can see people walking around and shouting.
Shut up, John.
You think they're crazy? No. That means they have attended my training before. And they're fighting with John every day. Okay? So the voice inside of you, and we call it John, is going to stop you from maxing out. And that's why we have DWDs. That's why we have VCON. That's why we have systems. That's why we have trainings to teach you how to kill John. If you manage to do that, I guarantee you, you will max out very fast. So in the beginning, it was difficult for me also, because I sat down like you and I listened to John most of the time. 90% of the time I listened to John, 10% I listened to Mike. Okay? Like, let me give you an example. How many of you smoke? How many of you smoke and tried to quit? You tried, correct? Every time you try, what does John say? One last one. So nice. One last one. And you listen and you smoke. That's why you still smoke. Correct? Because Mike says what? Day, you're going to die of cancer if you don't quit. Quit now. John said, no, how many people smoking got no cancer? One more stick doesn't matter. So who smokes again? Do you have a cigarette in your pocket? No? Why? You didn't carry. Oh. You got a cigarette in your pocket? Huh? See? From Thailand. Say, shut up, John. Yeah. Listen to John. You didn't bring, no? Oh? Lighter? Okay, now. So what happens now? Wait, after tonight, he'll go outside and John will say, hey, that shop sells cigarettes. Buy one box. VP Sathi won't know. But you're not doing it for me. Now, whether you smoke or not, it's a different matter. The point is, you must learn how to say, shut up, John. Okay. Sit down. What brand you smoke? Marlboro. It's in the hotel room. Huh? So you give up? Huh? You smoke? Huh? Where's the cigarette? See? I just want to see you. Give him. Okay. So there is one example of you always losing to John. Do you understand? So every battle you must start winning. And it won't be easy. Because John is very strong. You understand? When you write your name list, you write somebody's name and then you rub it off. Why? John says he's too poor. He's too busy. He's too rich. You know? I did a training many years ago and I told the crowd, why don't you show the plan to Vijay Mallya? Oh, he's too rich. Now he needs QNET more than anything. True or not? So write down your name list. Just say, shut up, John, shut up, John, shut up, John, shut up, John, and write everybody you know. Your job is not to judge whether they are too busy, they are too rich, they are too poor. Your job is to show them the plan. Whether they say yes or no, doesn't matter. You understand? Because there's a guy in Indonesia, his name is Tobing. And before joining QNET, he was selling coffee, earning $30 a month. $30 a month was his income. Now, would you show him the plan? No, you won't. You will say he has no money to join. Correct? John will say, don't show him the plan. Why waste time? He got no money to join. But somebody showed him the plan, and today he's one of the top earners in the company. You understand? So the voice inside of you doesn't want you to succeed. Okay? And together, we are going to fight and kill the voice and kill John. Okay? When you come for WeCon, and Dato Sri Vijay goes on stage, what does he talk about? What does he talk about? Talks about John. In a different way. But ultimately, every speaker that goes on stage is teaching you how to kill John. If Chief comes to DWD, he will tell the same thing. Correct? VP Kavita, VP Sachin, goes on stage, say the same thing. What did VP Vidyev Vadwani say? Kill John. VP Dave Joel. John is the wimp. Mike is the warrior. So you listen to John, you become a wimp. But it's not going to be easy. One battle at a time. Okay? I had help because I lived with my upline. Chief Patman was my upline. I lived with him in the same house. And his voice is very loud. I think when he was born, he swallowed a microphone or something like that. So John is very scared of him. My John is very scared of Chief Patman. So I could not hear John talking much because Chief's voice was very loud. Okay? So if you keep losing to John, then you need help. That's why you need an upline. You call your upline and say, I need help. I'm losing to John. Spend time with your upline and John will keep quiet. But when you're alone, you can hear him loud and clear. Correct? Sometimes when you show the plan, 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 and nobody is signing up, then you get frustrated. You sit in a corner and you start thinking, can this business work or not? That's John talking to you. Can this business work? Doesn't seem it's working. You showed 100 plans, nobody is joining. People who join quit. That's when you must say, shut up, John, and go out there and show one more plan. And show one more plan. Okay? How many of you get rejected when you show the plan? How many of you don't like rejection? Why? Rejection is part of the business. You don't like rejection because John tells you, one more gone. See, people don't believe in the business because this business doesn't work. But if you listen to Mike, Mike said, some will, some won't. So what? Someone's waiting somewhere. That's what Mike will say. So when you feel like giving up, when you feel like, I cannot do this anymore, what must you do? Shut up, John. Okay? This business is a daily business. If you fail today, there's tomorrow. So this business, do it one day at a time. Okay? And the most important thing you must remember is forget about yesterday. Just forget about yesterday. Every day is a brand new day. Okay? Because see, if I ask you now, in the next 5 days, sign up 2 new people. Okay? Hello? I'm not talking to you, I'm talking to her. In the next 5 days, sign up 2 new people. How many of you heard John? How many of you heard John talking to you? What did he say? How? You're in Thailand. You don't know anybody here. Correct? Immediately you heard him talk. That's when you must say, shut up, John. When are you flying back? Huh? 9. Today is 7. He said 7. So today is 6. You got 3 more days. Right? And then you fly back on the 9. Then you have 10th. Correct? And 11th. Can you not sign up 2 people? Can. But John will tell you why you cannot. See, on the flight back, can you sign up 2 people? Can. And I give you some advice. Don't sit together. I know you all like to sit together and watch a movie. Don't. Check in and say, give me a seat in between 2 strangers. How many hours back to India? 4 hours. You can show the plan to 2 people. And they cannot go anywhere. See, I have a dream. I have a dream which I have not fulfilled yet, and one day it's going to happen. I'm going to go and ask the pilot tell him, I need 1 hour. I want to go back and show the plan to everybody sitting in economy class. So I'm going to start like this. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I'm here. I'm going to show you something on how you can move from economy class to first class. This is you, one on the left, one on the right. That's all. You want the cigarette? Huh? No. So you're going to quit? Huh? Who's his upline? Where's the upline? Do you smoke? Next time you see him smoking, tell me. Okay? Huh? You don't have my number. Do you have Facebook? Can you find me on Facebook? Send me a message. And send me his IR number and name. Eh? Next time you see him smoking, send me his IR number and name. I will terminate his tracking center. Okay. Now who's your upline? Kumar. Okay, I'll talk to Kumar. If you don't, I will tell Kumar to send me your ID. But don't get me wrong. You must have fun building the business. You understand? Because if you're not having fun, then this becomes like another job. When QNET starts to feel like another job, then you will not succeed. Because every time you get up, another training. I must go and show the plan again. Yeah, so you call the prospect. How many of you have done this before? Call the prospect. The number you dial is not active. Ah, thank you. How many done that before? That means something is wrong. Why? That means showing the plan is hard work. How are you going to build QNET? Cannot. You'll fail. You must enjoy building QNET. Enjoy showing the plan. So I my bunch of my downlines came and cried, you know, so we have so many rejections, this, that. I said, okay. Write the number 1,000 on the wall of your house. Every time you get a rejection, slash and write 999. One more rejection, slash 998. Okay? When you reach zero, you can buy a new house. So now when you get a rejection, what happens? You get excited. You don't get upset anymore. Say, I'm going to reach zero. Yeah, the next time we meet, you just tell me the number, 349. Only 349 rejections to go, then we can sit together in first class. Understand? So rejection is part of the business. See, if I take this phone, and I give you the phone, and she says, no, I don't want. I give him, he says, no. I give him. He says, no. I give her. She said, okay. She takes it. So who lost? 1, 2, 3 lost. She gained. Correct? So the same when you show the plan. When somebody says no, it's their loss, not your loss. You understand? So when somebody says no to you, next time, say thank you. He says, why? He said, because you'll be working for me one day. So not everybody should join QNET. If everybody joins QNET, who's going to drive the bus? Who's going to drive the taxi? Who's going to work in the hotel? So when somebody says, no, thank you, and go and find the next person. Okay? Some of you have downlines, and the voice is very strong in them. They will try to convince you that this business is bad. You understand? So if you kill John, the John in your downline will talk to you through him. See, this John bugger is very smart. If you keep saying, shut up, John, shut up, John, shut up, John, he knows. He cannot talk to you. You won't listen. So he will talk to his friend to talk to you. So they come in different shapes and voices. The most common one is your mother-in-law. When she talks to you, shut up, John, shut up, John, shut up, John. So when your friends tell you this business doesn't work, it's not they are talking. The John is talking through them to stop you from the business. You understand? Then you switch on the TV. Bad news about QNET. What do you say? What do you say when you see bad news on the TV? Shut up, John. When you read the newspaper, shut up, John. Okay? You know who's a very dangerous John? Swami Googlananda. Now you're very smart. Everything, Google. You Google QNET, all bad news. What do you do? Shut up, John. Okay? Lot of bad news, then one good news. Read that. That is Mike. The bad news, shut up, John, and don't read. You understand? So many years ago, like 20 years ago, even in Malaysia, headlines in the newspaper, QNET is a scam. So I went to my upline, Dato' Sri. I said, what to do? Bad news in the newspaper. He said, stop reading the newspaper. That's his solution. I said, okay. And until today, I don't read the newspaper. My entire network stopped reading the newspaper. Because in the newspaper, only bad news. Rape, murder, politics. Correct? All John. They should call it the Times of John. So after tonight, when you leave, he will talk to you. Guaranteed. Guaranteed he'll talk to you. And he'll very nicely, psst. I know he told you to tell me shut up. But he doesn't know us. Our relationship. How many years we've been friends? And now one Malaysian comes and tells you not to be friends with me. Don't listen to him. Say, shut up, Sathi. That's when you must be strong. What's your name? Arjun. That's when you must say, shut up, John. You know, when you walk past 7-Eleven, when you walk past 7-Eleven, Marlboro will call you. Bro, long time we didn't talk. Let's talk. Let's meet. Okay? Marlboro is waiting for you at home. Correct? Sit down, sit down. Where are you from? Mumbai. Where in Mumbai? Thane, okay. Who's from Thane? That's where King John lives. The king of all Johns lives in India. That's why it's so difficult to say, shut up, John. Because you've been worshipping him for so long. Correct? What is the leader of North Korea, what's his name? Kim Jong-un, see? John. The president of the United States, what's his name? Donald J. Trump. What do you think the J stands for? John. Then in India, there's a guy. I think his name is Gurpreet Singh Anand. But his real name is Gurpreet Singh John. Now, the king's cousin lives in Vietnam. And don't laugh. The king's auntie lives in Kuwait. That's why you're not maxing out. Listen to the auntie. So together, we must kill John. Okay? That's why the V is here for you. We will help you to kill John. That's why all your uplines are here. That's why Date with Destiny happens. To help you to win the fight against John. You are not alone. Okay? You know, when a drug addict goes into rehab, what do they do in rehab? Every day, shut up, John, shut up, John, shut up, John, shut up, John. Until he kills John, then he comes out. Correct? So now you are in rehab to change your life. Your life for the past 30 years is, yes, John. Yes, John. Yes, John. Yes, John. From now on, you have to learn how to say, shut up, John. How many of you have been on a diet before? Okay? Why it did not happen? Why you failed? Because you put the rice, then you put the fish curry, and you eat, and then you said, little bit of rice. Second time. Because John said, the fish curry was so nice, and nobody's watching. Put little bit extra, doesn't matter. That's why you failed in your diet. Yes or not? Even in school, Mike says, study. There's an exam tomorrow. John says, there's a movie on the TV. No need to study. You can copy. How many of you copied your exams? Ah, see? See, when did you first hear John? When was the first time you heard him speak? See, how many of you have children? Okay, so your child is like 1 or 2 years old, walking, and then he falls down. What does he do? He'll get up again, but because nobody is around, okay? But it's many people around, and he falls down. What does he do? He cries. Why? John said, everyone's watching, cry. And he cries. And that's the first time your relationship started with John. True? And then you became best friends with him now. And then you decided to join QNET. When you decided to join QNET, you said, shut up, John. True? Now you got to keep doing it. How many uplines here? How many of you have downlines? You don't have downlines. Why are you not raising your hand? John said, don't raise your hand. You don't have downlines. Huh? No downlines yet. So you have to find 2 in 5 days. Huh? He's your downline. He's your upline. So tell him, shut up, John. And find 2 in 5 days. Okay? So, as an upline, you need to help your downline to kill their John. Okay? Because that's what Chief Patman did to me. And the best John killer that I know is Dato' Sri Vijay. His only job is to help you and me to win this battle. One day at a time. So, whenever you feel like you're failing, you feel like giving up, all you have to say to yourself is one more day. One more day. And I've been saying that since I started in the business. And today, it's been 22 years. And I still say one more day. Because I guarantee you, if you just say one more day, and don't quit. Even though you feel like giving up, you cannot do this anymore. The whole world is against you. You got no checks. You are spending more money than you're making. You just say one more day. Because if you don't quit, you will make it. I promise you that. Because the only way you can fail in QNET is if you quit. And the only reason why you will quit is because John wins. You understand? So from today, you must be different. Become a warrior. And every day fight. The more times you win, the stronger you become, and the closer you get to maxing out. And trust me, it's easy to say, shut up, John, when you're earning 10,000 a week. But when you're not earning checks, it's very difficult. Correct? But that's how we all started. That's how I started. I fell down, I got up again. I fell down, I got up again. I fell down, I got up again. I failed, one more day, failed. And suddenly one day you'll be standing on stage and telling people, "Shut up, John." How do you say "shut up" in Hindi? Chupre. Chupre, John. And again, have fun, guys. Have fun. This business is going to change your life. There's no other business like this. You can make $10,000 a week just by drawing circles. Which other business will give you that? The more circles you draw, the more money you make. When anybody asks me, "What do you do?" I said, "I draw circles." "What do you mean? Let me show you. This is you. One on the left, one on the right." Enjoy the business. This business is going to change your life. Once you learn how to say "shut up, John," then you will start to drive cars ending with "I." All this time you've been listening to John. That's why you drive cars ending with "A." Cars ending with "A" is Toyota, Mazda, Tata, Kia. What else? Honda. But when you learn how to say "shut up, John," then you write Ferrari, Bugatti, Maserati, Bentley. That's why my name is Sathi. Because my name 22 years ago was Sata. When I killed John, I changed it to Sathi. Okay? You made the right decision by joining QNET. Okay? I guarantee you that. And whatever you heard about in QNET, whatever you heard about QNET, it's not true. We are going to be around for a very long time. And the reason why we have so many problems is because people are jealous. That's all. It's jealousy. You see, a minister who's been working for 30 years drives a Honda. A networker who's been networking for 1 year drives a Mercedes. Won't the minister get upset? That's the why we have so many problems. It's all your fault. But it's okay. Buy more Mercedes. Buy more Ferraris. You understand? Because you see, because of jealousy, the whole world knows about QNET now. Correct? Everybody's talking about QNET. QNET, 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 QNET. Whether it's good or bad, they're talking about QNET. Our goal is one day to go on CNN. Then you know we are one of the biggest companies. I got just one more hour to go. See, your journey in this business is like climbing a mountain. Yeah? It's going to be difficult. But you climb one step at a time. And if you don't stop, if you don't quit, one day you will reach the top of the mountain. If you're tired, just rest for a while. Don't stop. And then continue again. You understand? If you get frustrated, you get angry, you get depressed, then cry for a while. And then continue. It's okay, I've cried many times. You know? My best downline quits the business. It's going to be, it will happen. Has it happened to you before? If it hasn't happened, don't worry. It will happen. I guarantee you, your top leader will quit the business. Your upline might quit the business. Has that happened before? Don't worry, it will happen. But you carry on. And when you're reaching the top of the mountain, if you look up, you will see all of us there, putting our hand to pull you up. Okay? So from today, make the decision. This business is going to work. And start the climb. And every time you climb and you want to give up, just say, "Shut up, John." Just say, just say, just say, "Chupre John." Who's from Vietnam? Okay. How do you say "shut up" in Vietnamese? Kam Yong John. Kam Bian John. Chupre John, Kam Jam Bon. Ah, Tamil? Vaya Murra John. Malayalam? Huh? Bundalela, I like it. Bundalela John? Marathi? Gabre John. So learn all the languages. Bengali? Subkor John in Bengali. Normus Korajon. Okay, so thank you very much. I hope you win the battle and Mike John. Mike wins. And I hope all of you kill John one day. Okay? Love you guys. Take care. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna